Hello and welcome. Our topic for the day is deciding when lines are parallel given two lines and a transversal. To understand the concept, let's do some questions. The first one says list all parallel lines, and we're given a condition that if measure of angle 8 is 56 degrees and measure of angle 4 is 124 degrees. Here we see two lines H and R and also A and D. And some angles are formed like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Here it says measure of angle 8 is 56 degrees. That is this angle, I'm marking it here. And measure of angle 4 is 124 degrees. That is this angle over here, I'm marking it. So these are the two angles whose measure is given to us. Let's see what is the total of these angles. Measure of angle 8 plus measure of angle 4. This is equals to 56 degrees plus 124 degrees. This is equals to 180 degrees. So here, measure of angle 4 and 8 is 180 degrees, or we can say that they are supplementary. When two angles on the same side of a line or a transversal, which is D in this case, are supplementary, then the two lines are said to be parallel. That is, H is parallel to R and D is the transversal. So we can say that here the two lines that are parallel are H and R, because interior angles on the same side of the transversal or adjacent angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, that we found over here. So H is parallel to R, which can be seen in option C. Let's try the next question. List all parallel lines. Here we're given some lines and some angles are given to us, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Some measures are also given. Let's write down. Measure of angle 1 is 20 degrees. Measure of angle 2 is 22 degrees and measure of angle 6 is 138 degrees. So we're given this angle, marking it 1, 2 and 6. Now if we see that angle 1, angle 2 and angle 3 are forming a straight angle, or they're forming a linear pair. So what we do is, in this case, measure of angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 equals 180 degrees. So from here, let's find out the measure of angle 3. Angle 1 is 20 degrees, 22 degrees, plus angle 3 is equals to 180 degrees. This implies 42 degrees plus angle 3 is 180 degrees. From here, subtracting 42 from both sides, we get measure of angle 3 as 138 degrees. Now if we see here, this is also 138 degrees, and it was given that measure of angle 6 is also 138 degrees. Now if we observe carefully the lines J and N, let's recreate them, I'm just drawing roughly. This is line J, this is line N, and this is the line K that's cutting it. And these two angles are 3 and 6. Now these are corresponding angles, and in this case we found that they both are congruent to each other. Now whenever corresponding angles are congruent, that makes the two lines J and N parallel to each other. This implies that J is parallel to N because angle 3 is congruent to angle 6, and these are the corresponding angles. So we found that line J is parallel to line N, which can be seen in option C. Let's try the next question. List all parallel lines. Here we're given few lines and also given that if angle 1 is congruent to angle 6, that is this angle 1 and angle 6. Now it says angle 1 is congruent to angle 6. This doesn't satisfy any of the conditions of the lines formed by parallel lines in a transversal. So we say none of the lines are parallel to each other. That is option C. I hope deciding when lines are parallel given two lines in a transversal is easy now. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.